Every week. Every puts the heart and the soul of everything into Padma. This workshop had been very important to him. And he loved coming here and discussing scientific progress in the eyes of history. I was looking forward to seeing him here. And the last thing I thought that I would be standing here speaking on him in the past tense. I was a postdoc in his lab for 7 years. And would like to share with you a little of my history with Eric and how much he influenced, contributed, and changed my life. I heard about Eric when I was looking for a postdoc position in biology. I was trained as a physicist. I didn't know he loved physicists, so I didn't know it. But I was trained as a physicist. I was fascinated by the miracle of embryo development. I talked to people that made the transition from physics to biology before me, and they told me about this guy that changed people's view of the regulatory control of development. I wrote to him, as well as to many other biologists, saying that I'm a physicist that would like to learn biology. Eric was one of the very few that responded to my letter. He wrote that he was intrigued by the abrupt change that I want to make in my research direction and invited me for an interview. I came for an interview in the winter of 2003. The lab was a vibrant place, full of highly intelligent people, excited about their science. Yet Eric and the complexity of gene regulation and development had scared me quite a bit, but luckily for me, he had invited me to work with him. My first few years at Eric's lab were the best years of my life until this time. It was 2004. Everyone was working on the sea urchin genome and deciphering the heart of gene regulatory networks. Eric Lab was like a sun after the winter, warming the scientists' seed in me and helping me to grow. Eric was extremely patient with me as I was learning molecular biology and embryo development. While he was waiting for me to develop into a mature experimentalist, he generously offered me to write reviews with him. We wrote 5 reviews together about gene regulatory networks and the quantitative aspect of gene regulation. So he had waited quite a while for me to produce actual data. This writing experiences, although excruciating at times, were highly educating for me. They gave me the basis for my own path that I'm forging now in my own lab to incorporate quantitative measurement with mathematical modeling for better understanding of developmental processes. He wouldn't like what I'm doing now, actually, but I think he will love it in the end, I hope. They gave me the basis for... Eric had introduced me to Ute, that had invited me to speak in the 2010 workshop here. This visit at 2010 opened my way to my current position at the Haifa University, so I'm endlessly indebted to him for showing me how exciting science is and pushing me hard to fulfill my potential. So about pushing hard, I must admit that working with Eric wasn't all rosy. He had challenged me, criticized me, made me feel small and doubt myself, and showed me that I need to work really hard to improve. But arguing with them taught me how to base my arguments on logic and solid data and design good experiments that will prove either him or me wrong. Sometimes he was wrong in the details, but he was always master at seeing the big picture. His ability to synthesize the complicated data into novel understandings, to draw the lines between the dots and generate a spectacular view of how things really work, had always left me at awe. One of the nicest traditions in Eric's lab was the dim sum farewell party held for long-time survivors of the lab. Right? Eric's farewell speeches were genuine and reflected his true opinion of the person that left. So obviously I was a little worried when it was my turn. To my utter surprise, Eric said that he had learned from me. It was one of the best compliments I've ever heard from him, and I will always remember it. When I left his lab and started establishing my own lab, I understood the difficulty of being a mentor. I asked for his advice for picking people for my own lab, he told me that he always looks for intelligence and spark, and that these two are the most important qualities he's looking for, more than what people did in their past. In my last letter to him, the day before he passed away, I told him how much I wish he could visit my lab. It was just before this meeting. I told him that I shaped my lab a lot like his, and I did it both in the physical space and the scientific atmosphere I'm trying to create. The love for science and the drive for excellence. I find his spirit in everything I do. Eric pushed me to develop my own lab. Sorry for getting so emotional here. I find his spirit in everything I do. Eric pushed me to develop my own language of science, and I will always be grateful for him for that. I wish he was physically here with us today, but in so many ways he is, and will always be.